Hello guys, and welcome back to another video that is ready for liftoff. If you think 2019 and onwards have been tough years, think again. Yep, that's because the solar system has decided to send, or rather hurl, another surprise package, all wrapped up and labeled as Berard and Ellie Bernstein at your earthly doorstep no later than 2031. Confused? Scared? Or just don't know what to think? Don't worry, we got you covered. But before we sort out your disarrayed emotions about who or what Berard and Ellie Bernstein is, let us stop you right there. That's because if you're enthusiastic about keeping up with the latest inventions, electric vehicles, and strange events occurring in the spatial dimensions beyond our own, then welcome! Because in our channel, we provide you with the best visual and auditory outer space trips. And that, too, while seated in the backseat of a Tesla car. An imaginary one, of course, wink wink. So buckle up tight, because you're in for a bumpy ride. And with that said, let the engine roar! Coming back to the point, did you know that according to NASA, out of all the things that have hit our Earth and caused massive destructions in the past, the most lethal of these celestial culprits are asteroids, meteors, and comets? And while we don't want to be the harbingers of doom, let's just say that history might be repeating itself really soon, in the span of just 9 years. But notice that we said might, and not will. That's because, for starters, Berard and Ellie Bernstein, named for astronomers Pedro Berard and Ellie and Gary Bernstein, who first discovered it, is one of the largest Oort cloud comets that was accidentally found after a 3.5 million year gap of finding one of its kind. Astronomers Pedro Berard and Ellie and Gary Bernstein indeed discovered a comet in the Oort cloud, which is a distant region of the solar system known for housing trillions of icy objects, by total accident. Yeah, you heard that right. It so happened that during their dark energy survey, Berard and Ellie and Bernstein were analyzing over 80,000 images to study the potential of creating a map of the observable and self-expanding universe. To give you a perspective on how huge this comet actually is, Berard and Ellie Bernstein is more than the total width of Lake Erie, the fourth largest of the five Great Lakes of North America, having a width of 57 miles. Now that's a gigantic comet right there, folks. However, the size of the comet wasn't the only thing that blew Berard and Ellie and Bernstein away. Rather, what fascinated the both of them even more than the comet's gigantic size was that after a closer look, the comet was actually in an active state with its long tail out. An absolutely mind-blowing discovery, to say the least. Can't quite grasp the excitement? Here's the reason why this is such a big discovery. You see, usually comets form a tail when they start nearing the sun. That's because the heat waves radiating from the sun and surrounding stars make the comet's icy surface warmer over time until it starts to evaporate, and this forms a cloud of steam and dust that stretches far and looks like a tail coming out from behind the comet. But in the case for the Berard and Ellie and Bernstein comet, it's more unique because the comet was too far away from the sun when it was discovered, and yet, it was still active and had a tail, which could ultimately mean only one thing. If the comet was warm enough to form a tail, this meant that the comet's surface was made up of a different composition, which scientists now believe to have been made of solid carbon monoxide. And it was this exact carbon monoxide component that not only increased the luminosity of the comet, but also formed its tail, making both observable by telescopes on Earth. If this doesn't get the science enthusiast in you excited, then we don't know what can, right? So, now with the introduction out of the way, not to make you panic or anything, but this Berard and Ellie Bernstein comet is barreling at top speeds towards the inner solar system right now as we speak. Should you run for your life? Maybe not. That's because if you missed the part earlier, we said the comet might cause destruction, and not that it definitely will. Let me explain. There are three very plausible reasons why Comet Berard and Ellie Bernstein might not cause apocalyptic destruction on Earth after all. One, the first possible reason is that if a gigantic comet Berard and Ellie Bernstein approaches the Earth from the Oort cloud, it's bound to experience substantial tidal forces from Earth's gravity, which will ultimately tear it apart into a series of smaller fragments. Or better yet, if the comet's nucleus is broken up before it hits the Earth's gravitational force, it's likely that the comet will miss the Earth entirely. Number two, whereas the second plausible reason is that if an object is to strike the Earth, the object needs to have a speed that should generally fall somewhere between 50 and 60 kilometers a second to create a proper impact. To give you a fair comparison, this is triple the speed that an asteroid impact typically possesses. And because kinetic energy depends on the velocity squared, so 3 times the speed means 9 times the energy, All of this boils down to the fact that if Berardinelli, Bernstein, and Earth were to collide, the cumulative amount of energy they would release would be somewhere around 10 raised to the power of 28 joules. Therefore, if we round up all the calculations, the second reason why the comet Berardinelli-Bernstein might not succeed in destroying the Earth is that it would require about 20,000 times more energy than the expected collision between Earth and comet Berardinelli-Bernstein would produce to cause unimaginable destruction and force life to become extinct. Conclusively, because neither the Berardinelli-Bernstein comet nor our planet Earth is capable of accumulating this amount of energy, the good news, the Earth will remain intact. Whew, right? So, the news of the comet Berardinelli-Bernstein not being able to destroy the Earth on its current path through the solar system should have most of you feeling relieved and ecstatic. However, if you are one of those people who love a good adrenaline rush and thrill by watching apocalyptic and doomsday movies and were eagerly awaiting for the misery to unfold, don't worry, we got you covered there too. Or if you were really worried or curious about what life would actually look like if the collision were to happen, don't worry because we never disappoint our viewers or leave them in the dark. With that said, here are some irreversible damage that would occur if comet Berardinelli-Bernstein and Earth were actually to collide. First things first. In the case that comet Berardinelli-Bernstein does succeed to remain intact as a solid object and hits the Earth, it will not only completely smash, but also shatter the crust everywhere across Earth's surface. As a result of this shattering, the Earth covered in debris and ashes will completely block out the sun, which means months of complete darkness and then ultimate extinction of life on Earth due to the lack of sunlight. The smashing of the crust will bring up the Earth's magma to the surface. This will obviously kill everyone on site, including the creatures that live around hydrothermal vents at the bottom of the ocean. This is because an impact of this colossal collision will smash the Earth so hard that the outer layers of our planet, including the atmosphere and oceans, will be kicked into space. And last but not the least harrowing effect of the debris falling back on Earth and starting raging firestorms will ensure the extinction of any living being who somehow managed to survive by then. So, these were some of the apocalyptic imageries that would unfold as a result of the collision. And we definitely don't want to witness any of these, right? With that said, whether comet Berardinelli-Bernstein will collide and cause apocalyptic destruction on planet Earth or evaporate in fragments, only time will tell. Until then, stay hopeful and positive because remember, there have been so many doomsday predictions before, but none of them came true, and the best part is that you survived all of them, didn't you? Shows that every cloud does have a silver lining, eh? And better yet, if you subscribe, give the video a thumbs up, and hit that notification bell, maybe we'll give you guys an update of how we survived in 2031. Wink, wink. We hope you enjoyed our video and we'll see you guys in the next video, so stay tuned. Until then, bye for now.